scrambled egg whites, a vegetable smoothie, or whole grain cereal with low-fat milk. That's how pop megastar Beyoncé described a bootylicious breakfast a few years ago. However, eating cereal has declined by over 11% over the past 5 years, with 40% of millennials dismissing it as inconvenient because it involves washing up. Meanwhile, the kind of farming that produces bacon and sausages is criticised for contributing to climate change through the carbon emissions it produces. So by the year 2039, meat, cereal and even dairy may be much harder to find on the breakfast menu. Instead, you might be tucking into a plate of insects. According to researchers in the Netherlands, insects cost less to raise than cattle, consume less water and don't really leave a carbon footprint. Plus, in many cultures around the world, in fact 30% of the planet's population, they're already considered pretty tasty. Robin Shapiro, founder of Seek Food, says, "Crickets are earthy and nutty, which makes them good to pair with nuts and granola. So while a rasher of bacon may become an illicit luxury only available in a fancy restaurant, crunchy nut cricket flakes could mean starting the day with a bowl of creepy crawlies from your garden biosphere. Probably not if you're vegan or vegetarian, like 1 in 8 Britons now are. Or how about lab meat, grown from animal stem cells, with no need for real-life pigs or chickens to become dead ones? A guilt-free slice of black pudding where there's blood on the plate, but not on your hands. Maybe the thought of this has you desperately reaching for that one cup of coffee you're allowed per year, thanks to climate change rationing. Researchers and chefs, including Heston Blumenthal, have discovered that what you hear can affect what you taste. So in 2039, your coffee might seem like it's full of sugar, even though there isn't anything sweet in it apart from the sound of music. With immersive dining experiences on the rise, from medieval banquets to murder mystery stories, or even a gastrophysics journey through space, could breakfast of the future be less about traditional tastes and more about living out your culinary dreams in a flavour-filled fantasy land? By 2039, it looks like most of us, 70% in fact, will live in cities. To cut transport costs, maybe we'll want to grow the onions to go with our stem cell sausages more locally. However, if the current housing crisis continues and luxury flats fill in every remaining space, where would we plant our greens? Perhaps the answer is underground. In cities around the world, this is already happening. Urban farmers swap sunlight for LED light and use a system called hydroponics, where plants are grown in water. So there's no need for soil, despite being surrounded by it. Perfect for farming seaweed, widely considered a sustainable superfood of the future. With cities increasingly full of people and traffic by 2039, we may need new ways to transport the ingredients that end up in our breakfasts. Could this be where drones fly in? Following the rise of takeaway delivery services, a company in China has been trialling drones as a way of getting food to customers. If this takes off, maybe delivery drivers will be a thing of the past. However, would you be happy to have a drone rather than a person popping by with your music-infused coffee or seaweed sandwich spread? With increasing numbers of us working flexibly, perhaps the need for a quick breakfast before dashing off to work will no longer be necessary. Maybe instead, we'll start to actually treat breakfast as the most important meal of the day, rather than just talking about it. But whatever's on your wheat bran plate, you probably won't have to wash it up afterwards because you'll be able to eat it. Great news if you're a 57-year-old millennial.